And they made the improvements. Listen to the people.
Residents spoke. Tourism Kelowna heard. Old concepts have been trashed, and this new design for the Waterfront Visitor Center is welcomed.
It's going to be a very large plaza area. It's about 15 meters wide. This is not a large building. It's quite a small building designed to be very glass, so see-through, so you can still really engage with the waterfront.
And the public seems engaged.
It's reasonable. It's a much better solution than they had before. They've taken away the office space. That was a bone of contention. They're protecting the waterfront. It probably is more workable than any other solution.
There's lots of positive changes that they've made, and they've encompassed a lot of consideration for tourism, the locals, and I think it's a positive move.
I think it's fabulous. Yeah. I'm glad they've done away with the top story, and I like the idea of the glass and where it's located.
Currently, the tourism center only sees about 20,000 visitors per year, a declining number as vacationers are planning their time differently.
They're researching where they want to go online. They're quite often making their reservations online. But once they're actually out on foot and they're experiencing the location, they really want to talk to somebody. So this location is really about capturing that the walk-by traffic. We estimate that it's about 400,000 people that we could attract and really get in touch with.
The cost of the project is $2.8 million, and Tourism Kelowna will have to raise or borrow the funds for the project, as the City of Kelowna isn't contributing any money. Following this open house, the project will return in front of City Council, and as long as everything is all good, this project could be completed by 2018. For Castanet News, I'm Jen Zielinski in Kelowna.